Hi everyone and welcome to this new Twinmotion 2022.2 tutorial. Today we'll be talking about the new Sketchfab integration directly inside Twinmotion. Indeed, in the last version of Twinmotion, we added a new folder in the library, here Sketchfab. We integrated indeed the Sketchfab library that brings around 700,000 new assets directly available inside Twinmotion. Those assets are not installed locally on your machine. Those assets are available on the cloud, available on demand. So that means that if you want to use one of those assets, you will first need to download it locally. Make sure actually to be logged in. If you are not, you won't be able to download any of those assets and that download icon will be grayed out. If you are launching Twinmotion through the Epic Games launcher, this is done automatically. So here, for example, now if I click on the download icon, I'm going to download that blue whale. And let's have a look at our project. Here I can simply drag and drop dataset on my ocean. It's quite big right now, so let me just scale it down to something like that. So in my project, it's not exactly what I wanted to use in terms of assets. So let's come back to our terrace here. And here what I'm going to use is some architecture props. Here I already downloaded a couple of assets. For example, here I can simply drag and drop that modern sofa. That object here seems a bit too small. So if I'm using the scale tool, I can simply scale it to the size I want. Any Sketchfab asset reacts as any Twinmotion asset, so here I can simply rotate it and scale it as I wish. It's the same idea with the material. Here, for example, if I come a bit closer, that sofa came with its own material. But I can select the material picker, pick the materials, and I can customize it. So for example, here, if I want to have something a bit more colory or just a bit more dark, I can do it that way. So apparently that specific object doesn't have one single material for all the mesh. But if I want my wall sofa to be darker like that, or maybe to be a bit warmer, what I can simply do is select the color I want, click on store to save the color, click on OK, and I'm going to apply the same color to all the different parts of my sofa. Something like that. Let's have a look now at another object. Like here, I can now drag and drop that sofa, chair and table from Isaac. Same thing here, that object is a bit too big. If I move it next to my other object, as you can see, the seating has not the same height. So I'm going to press the scale icon. I'm going to scale down that block of object so it fits a bit nicer my project. One of the limitations of the Sketchfab integration is that all the objects are completely collapsed when you drag and drop them inside the scene. So here, it's a single object. It's not a folder that you can expand where you find multiple meshes. We do that in a matter of optimization and also because that library of assets is created by many different users that have their own hierarchy. So to have something easier to use, all the assets are collapsed as one single mesh. If you want to keep that hierarchy, what you can do is select the asset, click on Open in Sketchfab. The first time you arrive on the Sketchfab website, you will need to create an account to download any asset. You can do that using your Epic Games account you use to register for your Twinmotion license. And here, that asset, I'm going to click on the download 3D model and I'm going to download that as a glTF file. Because indeed, in that last version of Twinmotion, we now support the glTF format. My asset has been downloaded. I'm going to come to the import doc. I'm going to click on import, open. I'm going to select my file and click on Keep Hierarchy. By default, that mesh has been imported in the center of the Twinmotion world. So what I can do is select it and press on F to focus on it. What I can also do if I want to stick to my original view is select the object, press Shift, click somewhere in my viewport. That will bring the selected object exactly where I want. So now that I have this object directly available inside Twinmotion, as you can see here, now we have a folder that contains all the different hierarchy of those objects. So for example, here we have a folder that contains just the coffee table. So I can take that folder and move the coffee table away if I want. Same thing here with that sofa. The Sketchfab library is a library of assets created by the community. Unlike the native Twinmotion asset and the Quixel Megascan asset that are created by the Epic Games team, the Sketchfab library is created by a community of users. That means that when you are using one of those assets, you need to credit the creator of that specific object. So for example, here, the first sofa I use came from 3D Alban, and that pack of objects here came from Isaac. If you want to retrieve easily the credit line, on the Sketchfab website, here you can copy the credits. But also directly inside Twinmotion, when you select an object, here instead of the statistic, you can switch to the metadata, and you can see that that asset, the name of the asset is in the name of the scene graph, has been created by Isaac, Taco the 3D guy. And that's the license that allows us to use that asset. Let's have a look at another object. So for example here, let's say that we would like to add a candle. So I'm going to tap actually candle in the library. Here there is, so we have some ones that will fit like an old style project. I want something a bit more modern. That one should probably not work if there is no air for the fire to burn, but that one looks actually pretty cool. So I'm going to click on the download button. And I'm going to drag and drop that on my table. Some materials are also not well supported coming from Sketchfab. And that's the case actually with that candle. Here, the glass material didn't came through. But no worry, because in Twinmotion, you still have access to the materials library. So I will come to the material, glass. Here, I'm going to drag and drop that item glass onto the glass itself. Also, for the candle here, I'm going to use a material toward the bottom. We have a translucent, a simple white translucent will do the job nicely. Finally, what I could do with that candle is select the flame here. I'm going to copy the diffuse texture. I'm going to raise the glow. By default, when you raise the glow, it turns yellow. And here, what I'm going to do, oh, actually, there is already an emissive texture in that candle, so that's perfect. So that means that now, if I'm switching to the path tracer, we don't have a simple white glowing fire. We have actually a yellow one. We can even link an omnidirectional light on top of that. So here I'm going to place my omni light just where I have my flame. I'm going to lower the intensity. I'm going also to turn on the shadows. Something like that will work nicely, especially if we switch to the night maybe. And that's it for this video. Thank you everyone for watching it, and then we will see you all for the next one. Bye everyone!